Well, good morning everyone and welcome as we gather today for this Remembrance Sunday. We come together to remember those whose memory we treasure, those who in disability and pain continue to suffer the consequences of war, and also those who have died for their country. It's a privilege to be here this morning officiating and sharing this time with you. We turn to the service sheet. Grace, mercy and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
And also with you.
This is the day that the Lord has made.
Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
So we have our first hymn, number 10, Abide with you. We come together to remember before God those from our community and throughout the world who have died in the two world wars and other more recent conflicts. We offer our gratitude for their devotion to duty and their sacrifice. As we recall all that they gave in the service of others, so we remember too our armed forces today, who display the same devotion to duty and sacrifice in the conflicts of this present time. Psalm 46. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble.
Therefore we will not fear, though the earth should change, though the mountains shake in the heart of the sea.
Though its waters roar and foam, though the mountains tremble with its tumult.
There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy habitation of the Most High.
God is in the midst of the city, it shall not be moved. God will help it when the morning dawns.
The nations shrink up in the kingdoms totter, he utters his voice, the earth melts.
The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge.
Come, behold the works of the Lord. See what desolations he has brought on the earth.
He makes wars cease to the end of the earth. He breaks the bow and shatters the spear. He burns the shields with fire.
Be still and know that I am God. I am exalted among the nations. I am exalted in the earth.
The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end.
Amen. I have our first reading.
The first lesson is taken from the book of the prophet Isaiah, chapter 2, beginning to read at the third verse. And many people shall go and say, Come ye, let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob. And he will teach us of his ways, and we will walk in his paths. For out of Zion shall go forth the law and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. And he shall judge among the nations and shall rebuke many people. And they shall beat their swords into plowshares and their spears into pruning hooks. Nation shall not lift up sword against nation, neither shall they learn war any more. O house of Jacob, come ye, and let us walk in the light of the Lord. Here endeth the lesson. Thank you.
So let's please stand as we sing our national anthem. The second reading is taken from Matthew's Gospel, chapter 5. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when men revile you, persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. For in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you." Here endeth the lesson.
Hymn number 355,
I bow to thee, my country.
Thank you.
Churchman, Robert Greenwood Hutchinson, Thomas Jackson, Harry Keenan, Richard Edgar Newsom, John Pearson, Thomas Preston, William Gray Rawlinson, Herbert Shred, Frank Wilkie. Charles Edward Fishwick, George Arthur Frayson, William Frayson, Edward Proctor, Fred Simpson, Stephen Thomas Whiteside. They shall not grow old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun, and in the morning, we will remember.
We will remember.
Thank you.
you go home, tell them of us and say, for your tomorrow, we gave our today. Let us pray. Almighty God, King of kings and Lord of lords, we give you thanks for the devotion to duty of name in the service of the crown and the cause of freedom and justice. May this example always be acknowledged and his sacrifice remembered by us. We ask in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Almighty God, stretch forth thy mighty arm to strengthen and protect the armed forces. Grant that meeting danger with courage and on all occasions with discipline and loyalty, that they may truly serve the cause of justice and peace to the honour of your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Almighty God, the fountain of all goodness, bless our sovereign lady, Queen Elizabeth, and all who are in authority under her, that they may order all things in wisdom and equality, righteousness and peace, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, look in your compassion on all those in need, especially for those for whom our prayers are desired. Grant them the comfort of your presence. Let peace rule their hearts, and fulfil in them your perfect will, for the glory of Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And Almighty God, from whom all thoughts of truth and peace proceed, kindle, we pray, in the hearts of all people the true love and peace, and guide with thy pure and peaceful wisdom those who take counsel for the nations of the earth, that in tranquility thy kingdom may go forward, till that the earth be filled with the knowledge of your love.
Amen.
And together, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever.
Amen.
And let us commit ourselves to responsible living and faithful service. Will you strive for all that makes for peace?
We will.
We will.
Will you seek to heal the wounds of war?
We will.
Will you work for a just future for all humanity?
We will.
We'll turn again now to our hymn book, and we sing number 413, Eternal Partner.
Thank you.
evening. I didn't mention the talk on the sheet, but I'm afraid you don't have to listen for a few minutes or just remember those you've been on today. We're perhaps aware that this year the British Legion are celebrating the 100th anniversary of their poppy appeal, and they write, "Every poppy counts, and note that red poppies have been worn since 1921 as a show of support for our armed forces community, and that the poppy remains the symbol of remembrance and the heart of their poppy appeal." But what will we do with our poppy after this remembrance period? Are we just going to throw it away? Will we keep it for next year? Will it just lay in a drawer until we come across it in a few months' time? Or perhaps we do have a particular place in which to keep them. We all have different thoughts on this subject, and some may be artistic enough to collect them and then create some kind of artwork with them. Thanks to Sainsbury's, I believe that we now have the option to recycle them. And the British Legion say we can take them to our local Sainsbury's store when this remembrance period is over, where recycling units will be available till the 27th of November. But whatever we do, I think it must seem a bit unfair if we do keep and use the same poppy year after year, because the British Legion do need ongoing funds to enable them to carry on caring for service and their families. And of course, the poppy is for us a symbol of our remembering. And as such, it is appropriate for us to ask ourselves the question, what will we do with our remembering after Remembrance Day? On Thursday just gone, and again today, the household of there will be many acts of remembrance. What happens tomorrow, and the next day, and the next? Will we put our remembering away until next year? For some, that's definitely not what will happen, because for some, the remembering is much more personal, because with it comes mourning. Mourning what has happened to a colleague, a friend, a family member, a partner, a parent, a child. That, of course, isn't something you can simply switch in and out of in line with the calendar and just put away for another year. But for many of us, we are perhaps at a more of a distance as we share with others in our remembering. And while our remembering may not be as personal for us, it matters. How we remember and what we do with our remembering matters. What we do tomorrow matters, because if we just put our remembering away along with our poppies to one side, then we've not remembered rightly this weekend. Right remembering is about more than setting aside a day or two in a year to remind ourselves of the facts of war. Remembering rightly is about how we live in the knowledge of those facts. We've often been reminded of British casualties and fatalities during the more recent conflicts our country has been involved in, facts brought to us very vividly through the media. And sadly, behind each fact there was a person, and behind them a family or colleagues or a group of friends, a community, a nation that's different because of that one person. And today perhaps God will say to us, in all your remembering, don't forget you have a future to look forward to. For right remembering, honourable remembering, should include vision and hope for the future. God's ultimate promise for us is that he will dwell with us. There'll be no more crying, no more mourning, no more pain. As Isaiah prophesied, sword being beaten into plowshares, spears into pruning hooks. Nations will not take up sword against nation, nor will they train for war anymore. Will we get out of our cycles of violence and war? Because through his Son, Jesus Christ, God has shown all generations, since Jesus' years of ministry on earth, a different way, a better way, a peace. peaceful way to live with one another. And that different way is to continue with us, because there's no going back, there's only moving forward. And taking our remembering and our offering with us and living in the light of it. When we remove our poppy from the coat it's been on these recent days, let us think about what we will do with it and what we will do with the remembering that the poppy symbolises. Perhaps this year, as we don't recycle it, we'll put it in a place where it will continue to nurture in our remembering. And we are remembering people. We remember birthdays, anniversaries. We remember our loved ones departed this life. That culture has been long inspired by a group of people who gathered at an empty tomb, believing that death had had the last word. And the good news and the hope coming from that empty tomb was that its victim and the result of his voluntary sacrifice that came with it is the realization that death no longer had dominion over him or over those who followed him. What changed a defeated, frightened group of men and women into a community overflowing with life was their discovery that life has been transformed from tragedy into joy, that death no longer has the last laugh, because we have the promise of a place waiting for us in paradise when our earthly life is over. Until we're called to take our place there, may we continue to remember all those who have given their lives, striving for peace in our world, all those who have been victims of war, all those our poppies represent. And may our poppies be a reminder to us all that if we are people of peace, living life reflecting the life and teaching of Jesus, perhaps those we encounter will catch peacefulness, catch it like some beautiful infection, and become persons of peace themselves. And then through our remembering, peace will spread wider and wider in the world. Living our lives in this way will honour all those who our poppies represent today.
Let us pray. Dear Lord, our Father, we pray for the Church of Christ. May we in your church, and especially at St. Peter's, serve your purpose in all we do. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
We thank you for all your creation. Help us to find solutions to both climate and human needs in our society. We pray for the Queen and all those in authority that, at all times, a true future can be found. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We pray for the local community, for Phil Broughton and Lindale parishes. May we remember all those for whom belonging is difficult. We pray for the Carmel Peninsula Mission Community and our future, so that we can look after each other. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Lord, keep safe all who suffer through grief or poor health. Help others to support them at this time. We especially think of families who are separated and who need our help and protection. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
At this time of seasonal change, as we see the leaves fall, we pray for the departed and the communion of saints. Help us to be true to the memory of those who have fought and gone before us. May they be with you forever. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son,
our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
sing our final hymn, number 353, Angel Sweet. Render to no person evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted, support the weak, help the afflicted, honour all people, love and serve the Lord, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, remain upon you and upon those you love and remember this day, and all you pray for. Amen.
Amen.
So let us go in love and peace to serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen. Amen.